Good morning, church.
Good morning.
Beautiful Lord's Day morning. He's given us another opportunity to meet in his house of worship. We want to welcome you this morning to our morning service. We have a few visitors. Sister Netta, two granddaughters is with us this morning. Welcome. We have condolences going out to Sister Karen Christian and her family. Also, Brother John Bird and your family. We wish for you that the Lord will continue to bless you and comfort you like only you can in the loss and the losing of your Brother John, your sister, and Sister Karen, your mom, who happened to be also my aunt. So may the Lord continue to sustain us all as we go through these trying times. We live in a real world, as Brother James rightly says all the time. And we live in a world where these things happen, and we just ask God to comfort and be with us. But I'm sure this morning, if we put our heart into this service, it'll be like last Sunday, we'll get a good service out of it. Those who are watching online, we hope that something will be said this morning will also enlighten you and encourage you, and somehow, some way, maybe have you change your mind about what you're doing and what you want to do and come to the Lord. But welcome this morning to our morning service. What a beautiful, beautiful audience we have, and also a beautiful Lord's Day morning that we have. He has given us. God knows how to do all things, and he do all things right. Let us stand, please. I want us to get quiet. I want us to get in a worshipful mood to praise and to worship God. We're not here to see who's here or what they have on or what they don't have on. We're here to worship God. We're here to praise God, and we're here to get out of the service, each one of us. I quite often say that every service we have, there's something in it for each one of us. We got to try to get out of it what we can for ourselves. Yes. Quite often we miss the blessings by thinking of other things or participating in other things in our mind. So let us get quiet, please. Relax. Sister Latasha, to come and open the service for me. I want you to remain standing, and Sister Karen will lead us in the opening congregational hymn. Sister Latasha.
Let us pray. Our Heavenly Father, we're indeed grateful for the blessing of another day, dear Lord. Thank you for watching over each and every one of us through the night that has passed, dear Lord. Lord, we thank you for your great faithfulness, Heavenly Father. And we thank you, dear Lord, for giving the desire in our hearts, dear Lord, to be in your house of worship this morning, dear Lord. And even for those that are watching online, Heavenly Father, that's unable to fellowship with us, dear Lord, we thank you, dear Lord, for allowing them to do that as well. Lord, we know that it is in you we live, we move, and we have our very being, Heavenly Father. We know, dear Lord, that we can do nothing without you, Heavenly Father. And we are so thankful, dear Lord, that you allow your rain to fall on the unjust and on the just. And for your sun, dear Lord, to shine on the just and on the unjust. Lord, you're such a good God. Everything, dear Lord, that we have, dear Lord, we owe it all to you, Heavenly Father. And this morning, dear Lord, we just want to give you thanks. Thank you, dear Lord, for our congregation, for this church, dear Lord, for what we stand for, Heavenly Father, and for the freedom that we have, dear Lord, to come in here and to worship you, dear Lord, in the beauty of holiness, Heavenly Father. I pray this morning, dear Lord, that we'll forget about ourselves and just concentrate on you and worship you, Heavenly Father. Lord, help us not to think about what we have to do or what we haven't done, but let us just focus on you for a few moments that we're here, dear Lord. As your word go forth, Heavenly Father, we thank you that it will not return unto you void, Heavenly Father, but it will do what you would have it to do, Heavenly Father. Remember all those in our midst today, Heavenly Father, who may not know you as their personal Lord and Savior. I pray, O Lord, that you would soften their hearts, Heavenly Father, that they may see, dear Lord, your goodness towards them throughout their life, Heavenly Father, that they have come to this stage, dear Lord, and they still have not accepted you, dear Lord. Oh God, I pray that you would convict them this morning, dear Lord, through your Holy Spirit, that they may accept you, dear Lord, and go forth, dear Lord, knowing you, dear Lord, and serving you wholeheartedly, Heavenly Father. We thank you, dear Lord, for those that are of the household of faith, who labor among us, Heavenly Father, to continue to encourage, motivate, uplift us, dear Lord. Thank you, dear Lord, for the family of God and for the church that you're building, dear Lord. We pray, Heavenly Father, as this service go forth, dear Lord, your Holy Spirit will continue to minister to our hearts, dear Lord, and help us, dear Lord, to know that all that we have and we hope to be, we owe it all to you. Remember everything that will be done in this present service, dear Lord, the singing, the musicians, dear Lord, the offering, dear Lord, everything that will be done, Heavenly Father. We pray that it will be done to your honor, dear Lord, to your praise and to your glory, Heavenly Father. And we thank you, dear Lord, for your ministering servants who so willingly, dear Lord, go forth, dear Lord, and do your will and preach your word, dear Lord, to help us, dear Lord, to continue to walk in the light, dear Lord. Yes. Thank you, dear Lord, for all that you have done for us. Thank you for all that you continue to do. We pray, Heavenly Father, that you would continue to be with us throughout the service. Every opposing spirit, everything contrary, dear Lord, we bind it and we send it back to the pit of hell, dear Lord, because we know, Heavenly Father, that you are God Almighty and that nothing is too hard for you and nothing is impossible with you, dear Lord. So we thank you for your word and for the promise of the books, the words in your holy book, dear Lord. We thank you that we can stand and we can hold these promises, dear Lord, and for all that you have done and all that you continue to do. Help us, Lord, always to seek to give you and you alone all the praise, all the honor, and the glory as we tell you thanks. In Jesus' name.
Number 89 out of our church hymnal. Blessed be the name.
Church, that was good singing.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. Raise our voices to God. Brother Carlton, welcome back, sir. You were gone for a while. Welcome back. Sister Flora and Brother Wendell, welcome back. God has been merciful and brought you, took you away and brought you back. So welcome back. Those, if there's any others that have been away, we welcome you back. We know it's summertime, and we know we need to take a little break every so often to refresh and come back again. So welcome back, everyone, any one of those that have gone away and be back with us. Our scripture reading this morning is found in the back of our hymnal. It's page 469. It'll be responsive reading number 42. Sister Barbara will lead that from at this time. Sister Barbara.
Good morning, church.
Morning.
The gospel of for all people. Oh, sing unto the Lord a new song. Sing unto the Lord all the earth.
Sing unto the Lord, bless his name. Show forth his salvation from day to day.
Declare his glory among the heathen, his wonders among all people. And Jesus came and spake unto them, saying, All power is given unto me in heaven and in earth.
Go ye therefore and teach all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost.
Teaching them to observe all things whatsoever I have commanded you. And lo, I am with you always, even unto the end of the world.
Now after that,
and saying, The time is fulfilled, and the kingdom of God is at hand. Repent ye, and believe the gospel.
Now as he walked by the Sea of Galilee, he saw Simon and Andrew his brother casting a net into the sea, for they were fishers.
And Jesus said unto them, Come ye after me, and I will make you become fishers of men. Altogether,
and straightway they took to their nets, and followed him.
May God continue to add a blessing to the reading of his holy word.
Amen.
Thank you, Sister Barbara. We'll sit at this time and sing from our church hymnal, number 263, All in Jesus, Sister Karen.
Praise the Lord, I am made.
Listen to the announcements, please. Tonight, service begins at 7 with chorus singing at 6:45. Please come to be with us in our service. I know I'm not preaching tonight, but please come. Please come to that service tonight. Our Wednesday night is our young people's service at 7. Again, every person that have a young people's meeting have a different young people's meeting.
Yeah. Yes.
So come out to enjoy that with us, please. They're always enjoyable. Next Saturday evening is our scheduled prayer meeting at 5:30. And next Sunday, God's willing, is back to our regular scheduled service at 9:45. Sunday school, Sunday morning worship service at 11. Sunday night service at 7 with chorus singing at 6:45. If there's any other announcements, Pastor will make them when he comes. I quite often when I share forget to bring in and mention about offering boxes. But the offering boxes, as you come into the front door, there's one on either side, and there's one to my right in the wing on my in the choir room, and the minister's room on my left. Just give to the Lord, and the Lord will give back to you, I promise you. And I'm going to make you a promise that everything you give to this church will be used to further God's work. We do nothing else with it. Nothing else at all with it. Praise the Lord for that. And we are a blessed congregation.
Amen.
We are a blessed church. We thank God for that. Nothing that we've done, but God has blessed us tremendously. Sister Georgia will sing for us at this time. Don't criticize him.
Please don't criticize him. He is the rock that I'm leaving.
times, even 12 more, and dive deeper into his word, and what a beautiful message he's been bringing. So please remember Brother James in your prayer, because I promise you, church, he's going through so much, but God is keeping him going. So we thank God for his leadership, and I don't know about you, but I thank God for Brother James. Praise the Lord. Brother James, may the Lord bless you, sir.
I'm very thankful for you being served this morning, and to see everyone that's here. I trust everybody is holding fast to that which you know is right and good. Last Sunday in the service here, I spoke on God's people in today's world, and I tried my best to show that God's blood-bought family and the wicked, sinful, corrupt, filthy practices of the world are two different ways of life.
Yes.
And in other words, God people are called out of that to take another course in life.
Yes, amen.
You can't refute that. That's what the Bible teaches. And today I will try my best to show that these two ways of life are dominated by two masters.
Yes.
Jesus Christ and the wicked enemy of our souls. I cried like a child when I prepared this message. I was preparing this message because I can read the text. You know, this text has always been emotional to me. When I thought of Jesus, and sister, that song was appropriate for what I heard this morning. When I think of Jesus Christ and his wonderful love, and God and his love for us, and where I could have been, what I could have been, where I could have been at this stage in life, it melted me to think of such a relationship that we could have with this great God. And I believe that more people are not attracted to God's way because it's a disciplined life.
Yes.
And I'm going to tell you the truth. I can't preach anything else but a Church of God message. And the Christian life is a disciplined life.
Yes.
In other words, some would like to go God's way, go with God, but only if they can dictate to him. That's not the way it works. You see, we live in a world today, especially this time age we're living in today, that discipline is a big thing. And a lot of children grow up into that environment. Little children, 5 years old, tell their mothers and fathers what they're going to eat. What they're going to wear. And where they're going to go. So they take that into adulthood. And they get in a problem with their manager on the job. And they get in a problem in the church. And that's not the way it is. That's not the way it works. And if you... I'm going to read a scripture first before I do the text, but if you look into the book of Romans, you will see here what I'm trying to say. And that is the 6th chapter of Romans and verses 1 and 2 before I read the text. What shall we say then? That's a question. Shall we continue in sin that grace may abound? God forbid. How shall we that are dead to sin live any longer therein? And the two texts are found in the book of Luke and John, both the words of Jesus written in your Bible in red. One verse in Luke is red. I'll read 3 verses above it or so. Luke chapter 4, beginning with verse 14. And Jesus returned in the power of the Spirit into Galilee, And there were a lot of fame of him through all the region round about. And he taught in their synagogues, being glorified of all. And he came to Nazareth where he was brought up, had been brought up. And his custom was, and he went into the synagogue and on the Sabbath day and stood up for to read. And there was delivered unto him the book of the prophet Isaiah. And when he had opened the book, he found the place where it was written. And these are the words of Jesus. The Spirit of the Lord is upon me, because he hath anointed me to preach the gospel to the poor. To the poor. The gospel to the poor. You know, poor. With this in your heart, you know, poor.
Amen.
This might be poor temporally, you know, naturally in the world, but you can be rich. To preach the gospel to the poor. He has sent me to heal the brokenhearted. To preach deliverance to the captives and recovering of sight to the blind, and to set at liberty them that are bruised. What a mission. What a mission into the world. And from the book of John, St. John chapter 10, and verses 9 and 10, the words of Jesus again, I am the door. By me, if any man enter in, he shall be saved, and shall go in and out and find pasture. The thief cometh not but for to steal and to kill and to destroy. I am come that they might have life and have it more abundantly. The contrast between two ways. Jesus described it there. Jeff described it there. The contrast between two ways. I have a couple of quotations here to read. And the first one is written by Will Durant. And I quote, Caesar hoped to reform men by changing institutions and laws. Christ wished to remake institutions and lessen laws by changing men.
Yes.
That's the end of quote. And the other one is by Henrietta Mears. And I quote, one of Jesus' specialties is to make some bodies out of no bodies.
Yes.
Remember that.
Remember
that you don't have to remain like you are.
Yes.
Nobody does.
That's right.
And the other one is from Homer G. Ray Jr. The most outstanding record that is given on the scroll of time is the date and birth of Jesus Christ. No issued document is legal. No signed check is valid. And no business receipt is of value unless it bears the statistical reference to this great historic event. End quote.
Yes.
You know, you're somebody.
Yes.
You're somebody.
Yes,
you're somebody.
Amen.
I told a Sunday school class there a while ago, don't let anybody make you feel inferior because you're a Christian. Don't feel inferior. Look at who you are. Look at what God has done for us. Look at what he continues to do. Look at the access we have to his provisions. Huh? Jesus lived on earth for a short time, you know. Very short time. A rewarding life. A wonderful life. Jesus was both human and divine. God's only son. In other words, God in the form of a man.
Yeah.
He came down here to understand the problem for humanity in person.
Yes.
What a story.
Yeah.
I had planned to sing that song this morning, but I didn't bother to tell them to sing it. Tell me the story of Jesus. Read on my heart every word. Tell me the story most precious, sweetest, that ever was heard. Don't slip away from it. Don't get too busy and came on today that you slip away from the real thing.
Amen.
Tell of this of this tell the story. Tell me the story most precious, sweetest that ever was heard. Tell of the angels in chorus sang as they welcomed his birth. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill. On earth, good tidings to earth. In other words, don't let it get stale. Don't die down. I'm begging you, Christian, don't die down.
Amen.
Keep up your level.
Yes.
Fasting alone in the desert. Tell of the days that are past, and how for our sins he was tempted, yet was triumphant at last.
Amen.
Tell of the years of his labor. Tell of the sorrow he bore. He was despised and afflicted, homeless, rejected, and poor. Tell of the cross where they nailed him, writhing in anguish and pain. Tell of the grave where they laid him. Tell how he liveth again. Love in that story so tender, clearer than ever I see. Stay, let me weep while you whisper. Love paid the ransom for me. I think of a lot of people, even in Cayman today, that have locked themselves into a shell. Nothing to do with this. Nothing to do with Jesus. Nothing to do with God. Nothing to do with Christianity. Nothing to do with church. There is more to life than that. And I read it here a while ago. Jesus made it clear that he came to give us life more abundant. That we might have life. That spiritual life he's talking about there. And that we might have it more abundantly. He walked around doing good everywhere he went. And he was instrumental in giving a lot of people hope. A lot of people hope and deliverance from misery.
Yes.
Think about that scripture I just read there.
Amen.
The brokenhearted, he came to heal the brokenhearted. What a savior. What a healer. His mission was a total person. Their complete wellness.
Amen.
We hear about wellness all the time these days.
Yes.
That's about heart trouble and diabetes and all that kind of thing. But Jesus came for the total wellness of us. Yes, you can have diabetes and heart trouble and cancer too. And you can still have the joy of salvation in his soul. You know how to let that conquer us and keep us out of heaven and out of joy of salvation. Having said that, with all that he did, he suffered. He also suffered. He also lived an exemplary life. In other words, he is who we follow, you know.
Yes.
He is our role model.
Yes.
Yes. Jesus was human. And we could, and divine. I said a while ago. But we could never be like Jesus. But we can try to live as close to him as we can.
Yes.
Christians are called to set an example to the world.
Yes.
Come on. Yes. To set an example to the world.
Yes.
As the representatives of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
How can people do what they're doing today and look like how they're looking and say what they're saying and expect to be representative of Jesus Christ? I don't understand. If you believe in Jesus, I'm sure you also believe in an enemy. Yes. Yes, Jesus had something to say about that too. I just read it there. The thief represents the enemy. The devil. Christianity, my beloved friends, is designed to improve people's lives.
Yes.
You must listen to what we're saying.
Yes.
It's designed to improve people's lives.
Yes,
And if you don't want that, you won't get it.
That's right.
Out of salvation, you got to go and get into this.
Yes.
People get what they want.
Yes.
Right? In most cases, get into what they want, get tangled up. Like fish tangled up in a net. Can't get out. People get tangled up all the time.
Yes.
Don't seem to find their way out. And believe that they're too far away from God and God will love them. That's not the case, friend. Living for the Lord is all about our souls. Not about entertainment. Excuse me again. It's not about entertainment. There's enough entertainment all about. Yeah? You can get it anywhere. It's about the souls of man. Yes. Jesus, in John 10, Jesus was referring mainly to leaders whose intent was to try to lead God's people for other means than that is genuine. Huh?
Yes.
And if you look at verse 13, it says, verse 12, but he that is in a hireling and not the shepherd, whose own the sheep are not, see the wolf coming and leaveth the sheep and fleeth, and the wolf catches them and scattereth them. The hireling fleeth because he's an hireling and careth not for the sheep. That's the Bible. Not our brother James, that's the Bible. Jesus is the chief shepherd and also the door. Right, if you look at 7, then said Jesus unto them again, verily, verily, I say unto you, I am the door of the sheep. There is no other tunnel that you can go through but Jesus to enter his sheepfold, his fold, the kingdom of God, the church. There's no other avenue but through Jesus. And verse 9, I read already, I am the door. By me, if any man enter in, he shall be saved. The thief can apply to this devil in the world today. Let's look at what he does. The word steal means to take from. There's a lot of stuff going on that came out today about stealing. Unfortunately, that is brand new. All this stuff you see going on came out of new. We didn't know that kind of stuff growing up here. Come on now. Could leave your house open and go. Work all day, come back, still so. Could park your bicycle at the post office and go to all day, work all day, go back, find it. Now, you see where the thief is now? You see what the devil does? He's having a big time. He's having a big time in this world. And far too many people are following him, expecting to be Christians. And think they're Christians and claiming to be Christians. It takes more than sitting on a choir bench singing to make one a Christian. Yes, he knows all about the world. Yes, he robs people of their good intentions.
Yes.
Good intention, always some excuse for leaving, not accepting Jesus, working for God. It's always some excuse. That's what he does. He gives excuses and excuses and excuses. You get all kind of things for people to look at it till it's too late. Procrastinating. And they get old and die. And I never saw him. Yes, he causes people to look at professing Christians that don't seem to be up to the mark. And so they stay away. Well, that person not going to answer to God for you. And because somebody is doing something wrong, that will give you a license to do something wrong. If you're wrong, you're wrong. Could be the biggest professor. If you're wrong, you're wrong. He gets people to believe that he's confused and don't really know who to believe. So they stay put. I'm telling you, it's amazing what's going on here. in regard to the truth of the gospel of Christ, people are losing it.
Yes.
In these islands today. This little island that used to be called the island that time for God, that has a heritage, a legacy of Christianity and respect and reverence for God.
Yes, sir.
Hmm?
Yes, sir.
It's been in the way. And every generation is getting farther from God. I'm telling you the facts of life. It's not to frighten anybody, I'm telling you the truth. I'm not talking about religion. It's easy to get into religion. That's easy. I'm talking about living for God. Come on, church, wake up now. I'm talking about living for God, living a holy life, upright, honest, integrity. Refuse to do wrong in any way, shape, or form. That's what Christians do. So, if you look at people, and you know, if you look at people, you'll miss it. You know how many people have been in this church last 40 years I've been in? And Brother Horace? Come and go, come and go, come and gone, long time. All those old established Christians still here. You know how to fall away because the society has changed like it is. Show society there's something better. That's what you got to do. Show them there's something better. You know how to go with the flow. I'm telling you, there's secularism. And came on today and not all over Cayman, but it's all over the world. But I live here. This is my little home where I've been for 80 years nearly. This is my little home. This is where I live. And when I think of the changes that have come upon us, you see, he robs people of their joy. He robs Christians of their joy. Yes, he gets people grouchy. Or no display of a real, radiant life. And you don't want to be around them. Hard? It's not hard. It's gospel. It's the kind of gospel I come up under. It's the only kind I know. And that's the Bible doctrine. The Bible gospel. Paul said, when about preaching another gospel, what's it? Something. Yes. No other gospel.
Right.
One gospel.
Yes.
The gospel of Jesus Christ.
Yes.
Yes. You can lose your radiance.
Yes.
The brilliance.
Yes.
The cares of life can get you down.
Yes, sir.
And you get old quick.
Yes.
Wrinkle up.
Yes.
Can't smile or laugh.
Yes.
Huh?
Yes, sir.
Happens all the time. You know,
yes.
You get people who believe an idea they're the only Christian in the church. Some years a woman came to see me. But when she finished with me, but when I finished with her, I say, "Mom, you're the only Christian in the church then." She never said no more. That's how they think, that's where they get. That's what a thief does. That's what the devil does. That's what a robber does.
Yes.
The only Christian in the church is them.
Yes.
And nothing they do is wrong.
Yes.
And they can do anything to anybody.
Yes.
And they're not wrong.
Yes.
Trust me, that's a tough kind to deal with.
Yes.
All they can do is stay put and don't ignore them.
Yes.
Only God can handle some cases.
Yes.
Hmm. Yes. I tell you, yes. He can rob Christians of their enthusiasm too.
Yes.
Many other things become more important than the spiritual.
Yes.
It's happening. You got to watch yourself.
Yes.
You don't get too over-involved in the secular things of life.
Yes.
You win your life, you know.
Yes.
Don't blame the church.
No.
No, don't blame the church.
Yes.
I'm sorry, but he steals people's marriages.
Yes.
and homes. That's what he specializes in. And if he can get the homes broken down, societies. Talking about this now, not about children these days. What happened in Cayman today is broken homes. Little children scattered all over the place. Don't even see their mom and daddy. Oh, rough. I believe in home life. I believe in home life. I'm still in home life. All being rough. And tough. I'm still in home life. I never deserted my responsibilities. You're no longer do it. No. He steals people's relationships. I don't like her, you know. I can't stand her. Too much of that going on in the world today. Who you like? Christians like one another? No, I don't like him. I'm going to shun him. Give him cold shoulder. Well, get on with life. Get on with life. Many people don't like me. Don't care for me. That don't bother Brother Gene. I have a responsibility to get to heaven. I must master my life. And when you get to the extent where somebody else is robbing you of your Christian service, you need some help. I'm not here to serve Sister So-and-so, Brother So-and-so, or to worship Brother So-and-so. I'm here to worship God and to live a life. To live a life for God. If somebody don't like that, that's their problem. Succeeds in getting Christians to neglect their own spiritual life.
That's right.
Oi. Yes, barely making it. Yes, some eventually die without. The coconut gone under the water, now come back up. The coconut water soak. Gone. No? I'm telling you facts. I've been this thing long time. They still look the same. They still look like Christians. All that. But that relationship with God. So they decide to slip out of the church and make it on their own. Let me tell you something. This is real. He eventually, if listened to, succeeds in pulling people out of the sheepfold from under the shepherd. So, what is the contrast? I am come that they might have life. Listen to what the Jesus said. In Matthew 5 or 6 things here. He came, anointed me to preach the gospel to the poor. He healed the brokenhearted. That's 2. To preach deliverance. If the devil can get you brokenhearted and keep you there, that's all he needs. A lot of people have brokenhearted hearts, so all kinds of situations. But you can't make it go too far. Deliverance to the captives. The captives. Helpless. Bound by habits and sin and evil. Recovering our sight to the blind. He opens blind eyes, spiritually speaking. I'm talking to now. He opens blind eyes and set at liberty them that are bruised, them that are injured, hurting. Jesus came to do. I am come, he said, that you will have life and have it more abundantly. Some people think that to have life is to have all they can get. In the most up-to-date stuff in the world to compete with everybody else. But you let me tell you a secret today. If you got money to buy a waterbed, that's your business. Rest. Take a rest. Yes. Not a problem with that. But that's not all there is to life.
No.
That doesn't make the abundant life.
No.
Amen. Can't walk on the floor. Not on my floor, you know. Yes. I just shine that.
Yes.
That don't make life.
No.
That don't make spiritual life.
No.
Cool. Yes. I am come that they might have life. He came to free us.
Yes.
That's why I had that song sung there this morning. I am free. I like that song.
Yes.
It's a very beautiful song for the church to sing.
Yes.
When you sing it, vibrant and nice. Yes. He came to free us. To give us power to live for him.
Yes.
To improve one's life. And you look at Galatians chapter 2, chapter 5 and verse 22, you will see there. The fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, long-suffering, gentleness, goodness, faith, meekness, temperance. Against such there is no law. And they that are Christ have crucified the flesh with the affections and lust. If we live in the Spirit, let us also walk in the Spirit. Watch how you walk. I'm not talking about that. Some people got a splash of walk these days, you know. They put on a new walk now. Depending on what it got on. And who they in front of? Walk natural. Walk how God made you. My step's getting short now. And I can hardly stand up here much longer. So it is. So it is. Yes, Jesus made it clear. And if you look back into Luke, that's what he said there. He came to give us life.
Yes,
and to give us life more abundantly.
Yes,
I am the good shepherd.
Yes, sir.
The good shepherd giveth his life for the sheep.
Yes, sir.
Jesus paid it all.
Yes, sir.
All to him we owe. Sin had left the crimson stain. He washed it white as snow. Anybody sit down in this congregation and lose it, don't blame Brother James. Don't blame any other preacher here. Don't blame any other member. Blame yourself. You see, what I drink into this body is my responsibility. What I see with these eyes is my responsibility. What I put on is my responsibility. Where I go is my responsibility. Be not tied with rope. But when you're under the shepherd, you go where he leads you. You're going to sing. Number 162. Since Jesus gave his life for me, should I not give him mine? I'm consecrated, Lord, to thee I shall behold it. My life, O Lord, I give to thee. Let it go. Get out of yourself and put God first. Let us stand.
Since Jesus gave his life for me, I'm
keep looking for something, we found it. I want to be quick to thank God for meeting with us this morning, for using Brother James again, and the way he helped to encourage us.
Thank you, Lord.
To look to God for all things at all times. Jesus, my friend, is our closest friend. And he's sticking closer than our brother. So if you need help, you need somebody, you need a good friend, Jesus is the answer. Praise the Lord. Let us try to imitate him. Let us try to live like him. Let us try to be more like Jesus. Don't try to be more like anybody else. My brother James, right, let's say, change the swag, change your walk, but be like Christ. Be you. Just be like Christ. Imitate Christ. Thank you for being with us. Come back with us again tonight, and I'm sure something will be said in that service, but also bless and edify your soul. Sister Virginia Bodman, you just missed the service for me, please.
Let us pray. Dear precious Heavenly Father, as we come before you as humble as we know how, Lord, thanking you for salvation. Thanking you, Lord, for your goodness, your mercies, your blessings, your love, your healing power, everything bestowed upon us. Lord, help us to love you more and to draw closer to you, Lord. Help us, everyone, to be better Christians. More loving, more kind, more forgiving. Lord, we ask you to bless each one this morning. And Lord, in the congregation, help each one to reach out to you, whatever their need might be, Lord. You are more than able to fulfill it, Lord. We ask you to bless the sick and the suffering, those that mourn, Sister Emily's family, Lord, and Mary's family, all the different ones, Lord. We ask you to comfort their hearts, Brother John's sister, and all of them, Lord. We ask you to comfort their hearts and strengthen them and help them to look to you, dear Lord. Now, Lord, we thank you for the message. We ask you to help us to be a little more like Jesus, because, Lord, we need to draw closer and closer to your bleeding side. Keep us faithful. Keep us true. Help us to worship you in spirit and in truth, and to be a faithful soldier of the cross. Lord, if we see someone not doing something that's right, please don't tear them down. Please pray to God for them and ask God to show them what is wrong in their life, that they can make it right. Lord, we ask you to help us to understand and know how to treat others. Bless us and keep us close to you, Lord. And as we go our separate ways now, take us home in safety. In Jesus' precious name, we ask these mercies. Amen.